My 5 minutes, and inshallah I will make it very brief, is on a group of people whom Allah had elevated amongst any other because of their sacrifice for this faith. Every prophet had those whom Allah surrounded them with, and the reason a lot of times for that was in order to give them the confidence and give them the motivation and inspiration for them to call people to the path of Allah. When you look at all of the Anbiya, every single Nabi had a companion amongst them. When you look at Nabi Adam, who was the first of creation, Allah created a companion for him that would support him in his quest for existence. You come down to Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, his companion was his wife and his nephew Lot. And you subsequently go down to every companion or every prophet, you will find that Allah had bestowed them with certain companions. And then we come down to the final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, whom before him the prophet Nabi Isa had the companions known as Al-Hawariyin, described as or called as the disciples. But for the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, his companions were called the Sahabas. And after the Anbiya that had walked on the surface of the earth, the next best group of people that came after them were the Sahabas of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They all sacrificed for the sake of Allah. And whenever they were commanded, it was never a case of we hear and do not obey. It was always sami'na wa ata'ana. And one of the greatest of them was described in the third rak'ah that was recited, or fourth rak'ah recited by the imam in the tarawih prayers that we just observed now, the first six units. This was describing Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the two who were trapped in the cave. إِذْ أَخْرَجَهُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا ثَانِيَ اثْنَيْنِ. The two, or one of the two, إِذْ هُمَا فِي الْغَارِ, when they were trapped in the cave, and one of the two said to the other, إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعْنَا. These two companions were Abu Bakr and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They had left Mecca heading to Medina, and they had left after all the companions that were to do hijrah had done hijrah beforehand, and they after followed. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam waited for everyone to leave. But before he would leave, the Quraysh had planned to kill him. And so they took out, or they hatched out the plan, and they went to his home and they tried to kill him in his home. But when they got there, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused all those that came to kill him to fall asleep. And as they finally got into the home, they met with a young man instead laying on the bed of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This young man was not afraid of death and not afraid to protect the Prophet. And who was this young man? Ali bin Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu. When they saw that it wasn't the Prophet, they began to trace him and chase him. And they got to see his tracks, and they followed him till they entered a cave. And when they entered this cave, that is the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam and Abu Bakr, Abu Bakr was filled with fear when he saw the Qurayshi pagans standing at the mouth of the cave, that if they just looked down, they would have seen them both and they would have killed them. So Abu Bakr became afraid radiallahu anhu. He was worried for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And in that worry, even without uttering a word, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told him, La tahzan, do not be afraid, do not be worried, Inna Allaha ma'ana, Allah is with us. This was Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. His own worry was not for his life, it was for the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When Abu Bakr was beaten in Mecca till he became unconscious because he fought or stood against oppression of the believers and also of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, as he became conscious, the first person he asked for was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When they got to Medina, the land that was bought for the masjid was paid for by Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. When it came to charity, there was none that was as charitable as Abu Bakr. And this was why the Rasul, in describing the gates, Abwabul Jannah, he said, all the gates will call the believers to come in through them. Abu Bakr said, I wish to be one of them. And he said, you will be called through all the gates of Jannah. Allah elevated the companions, and through them they were able to bring this deen all the way to us till today, that we are in our billions all across the globe. Allah used them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to know about them. And this is why in this verse that was recited, very important, it was the statement of Allah testifying to the fear of Abu Bakr. The verse was revealed to convince and to also console Abu Bakr that nothing will happen, that Allah is with you. And this verse applies to all of us here till the end of time, that when we hold on to Allah, la tahzan, we will not fear, you will not worry, we will not worry. Why? Everything will happen and vanish and cease. But because we hold on to Him, He will always be with us. May Allah come to our aid, and may He cause us to hold on to Him and believe in Him and depend upon Him more than we depend on anything in our lives. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.